And y'all gotta give it up for the best ring announcer in the world. His father was spectacular, and he's great also. I couldn't choose a better guy to do my fights. I want to thank you. Who else? We got so many different people in the room, because if I forget someone, and don't worry, you know, I can stutter, I can make a mistake, I'm not perfect, you know. God only made one thing perfect, that's my boxing record. So don't worry about that. I ran to Blade Barkley. He's either from the Bronx or Brooklyn, but I want to say the Bronx. The Bronx. He's from the Bronx. You know, he's one of the guys that paved the way for me to be where I'm at. I can remember when he fought the guy that you looked up to, the Hitman. And he was the Blade. He had Blade you. Great fighter. You know, I was really a student of boxing. Every single day I came home from school, all I did was watch VHS tapes, because back then in the 80s, it wasn't DVDs. It wasn't going to YouTube. It was all about what we call them VCR tapes, but VHS tapes. And that's what I watched every single day. And then I would go around my house and I would punch the doorknobs and I would punch the back of the chairs. And I mean, I was obsessed with boxing. I don't think no one in this room loved boxing more than me. And Kelly Swanson, my publicist. You got a little water for me? You get some, please. Thank you. Y'all, I can't be the man of the hour and just come up here and say, you know, be like the rest of those fighters. You know, a lot of those fighters come, you know, I do talk with my fist and say goodbye. I can't do that. Like I was saying, my publicist, Kelly Swanson, she's a beautiful person, a great person. And so many different publicists that work with so many other celebrities trying to cut her out, but I'm loyal to who I'm with. Me and her been working together over a decade. She's worked with another legendary champion, Bernard Hopkins, and every fighter that's in boxing, or every person that is in boxing, will tell you she's the same every day. We need more people like her in this world that's positive and have a great spirit. Barry Tompkins, I mean, just all the writers. I see everyone. I've been watching you from the beginning. You know, it was always a dream of mine for you to commentate one of my fights one day, and you did. And that was one of my dreams that came true. One of my dreams was to, fight on HBO. Then one of my dreams was to be the highest paid fighter, do the highest gate, and then I think out of all my children, my oldest daughter, I think she's the most happiest because she knows all about boxing. But she cannot be like Layla Ali. You know, I don't want her boxing. You know, I want her to go to college, and hopefully when I'm older, she's able to run any other promotions or run these different companies that I have. And, you know, take things to that next level, because that's what it's really all about. You know, giving back to our children, giving back to our peers, giving back to the young people. That's the future, to the young future writers. You guys are here, and they're gonna tune in. You know, they're gonna tune in on YouTube and different websites and see different writers up here talking. You guys paved the way for the new writers and the new commentators. So you got to give yourself a round of applause.